Each June, we celebrate Lesbian, Gay, Bisexual, and Transgender Pride Month. The spirit of Pride is found in local festivals, parades, and bright colored flags that represent the hope and optimism of a diverse community. In the Navy, this is an opportunity to highlight the service of LGBT service members in our Navy family, as well as the veterans who have gone before us. This year, in 2020, our CFAY Multicultural Committee has produced a collection of videos that highlights some key contributions of the LGBT community over the years. I hope you'll take time to enjoy these stories and remember those achievements with us. Our Navy is comprised of a diverse collection of sailors from all walks of life and every background, including sexual orientation and gender identity. Together, we're a fierce warfighting team, and during our Pride events, we lift up and celebrate the contributions of our LGBT shipmates who strengthen our Navy team and its mission success. So enjoy the presentations from our Multicultural Committee, and happy Pride, CFAY!
The 1970s were a landmark decade for the LGBT community. On the first anniversary of the Stonewall riots, the first Gay Liberation Day march was held in New York City, while the first LGBT Pride Parade was held in Los Angeles. In 1971, Dr. Frank Kameny became the first openly gay candidate for the United States Congress. The University of Michigan established the first collegiate LGBT programs office, then known as the Gay Advocacy Office. In 1972, East Lansing, Michigan, Ann Arbor, Michigan, and San Francisco, California became the first cities in the United States to pass a homosexuality rights ordinances. Jim Foster and Madeline Davis became the first gay and lesbian delegates for the Democratic Convention. The first lesbianism course, Lesbianism 101, is taught in the United States at the University of Buffalo. In 1974, Kathy Kosciuszko became the first openly gay American elected to public office when she wins a seat in the Ann Arbor, Michigan City Council. 1975, homosexuality is legalized in California. In 1976, Robert Grant founded the Christian Voice to take his anti-homosexual rights crusade national. In 1978, Harvey Milk was the first openly gay elected official in the history of California. Later that year, he and Mayor George Moscone were assassinated by former supervisor Dan White. And in closing, in 1979, the first National Homosexual Rights March was held in Washington, D.C.
Hello, CFAY. My name is MC2 Frazier, and in recognition of LGBT Pride Month, I would like to speak a little bit about the history of the LGBT community in the 1980s. In 1980, the United States Democratic Party becomes the first major political party in the U.S. to endorse a homosexual rights platform blank. And in the same year, the Socialist Party nominated an openly gay man, David McReynolds, as America's first openly gay presidential candidate. In 1981, tennis player Billie Jean King became the first prominent professional athlete to come out as a lesbian. Due to this, she lost all of her endorsements. In 1982, Wisconsin becomes the first U.S. state to ban discrimination against homosexuals. In 1983, Massachusetts Representative Jerry Studs reveals he is gay on the floor of the House, becoming the first openly gay member of Congress. In 1985, Terry Sweeney becomes Saturday Night Live's first openly gay male cast member. In 1986, Becky Smith and Annie Affleck became the first openly gay lesbian couple in America granted legal joint adoption of a child. In 1987, a group of 75 bisexuals marched in the 1987 March on Washington for Gay and Lesbian Rights, which was the first nationwide bisexual gathering. In 1988, Robert Dover became the first openly gay Olympic athlete. And in 1989, Long Beach, California prohibits employment discrimination based on sexual orientation in the private sector.
Hi, I'm Iaswin Allen, and I'm here to talk about the LGBT movement during the 1990s. The 1990s saw progress for the LGBT community, both in legislation and in its normalization in popular culture. In 1994, President Bill Clinton instituted the Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy, which allowed gay and bisexual men and women to serve in the military under the provision that they kept their sexual orientation a secret. While the policy still barred service members from being openly gay, it prohibited the military from inquiring about or investigating a member's sexual orientation. The policy would later be repealed in 2011, allowing openly gay men and women to serve in the United States military. In 1996, the United States Supreme Court made a landmark decision in favor of gay rights. The case, Romer v. Evans, challenged a state constitutional amendment in Colorado, which denied protected status against discrimination based on homosexuality or bisexuality. The Supreme Court ruled that the amendment did not satisfy the Equal Protection Clause, and the ruling set a precedent for future Supreme Court cases that would lead to the federal legalization of same-sex marriage. Unfortunately, the 1990s also saw setbacks for the LGBT community. After the District of Columbia passed a law that allowed gay couples to register as domestic partners in 1992, Congress responded with the Defense of Marriage Act in 1996, which prevented the federal government from granting federal marriage benefits to same-sex couples and allowed states to not recognize same-sex partnerships granted by other states. The act would later be deemed unconstitutional. The 1990s also saw the high-profile murder of Matthew Shepard, a young man who was tortured, tied to a fence, and left for dead near Laramie, Wyoming in 1998. His murder brought national attention to the public treatment of the LGBT community, as well as to hate crime legislation in the United States. The Matthew Shepard Foundation, a nonprofit organization for LGBT advocacy programs, was founded in his memory. In popular culture, the 1990s saw the first same-sex kiss on television in 1991 with the show L.A. Law. The popular 90s sitcom Friends aired the first same-sex marriage depicted on TV in 1996, and in 1997, Ellen DeGeneres' character on her show Ellen came out as a lesbian shortly after the actress had come out publicly herself. The show went on to deal with various LGBT issues, with the coming out episode being one of the show's highest rated episodes.
My name is M.A.T. Jaron, and in recognition of LGBT Pride Month, I would love to talk about a few significant events from 2000 to 2009. April 26, 2000, Vermont becomes the first state in the United States to legalize civil unions and registered partnerships between same-sex couples. Not exactly where the community wants to be, but a necessary step to take towards equality. May 18, 2004, Massachusetts becomes the first state to legalize same-sex marriage. The court finds the prohibition of same-sex marriage unconstitutional because it denies dignity and equality of all individuals. In the following 6 years, New Hampshire, Vermont, Connecticut, Iowa, and Washington, D.C. will follow suit. October 22, 2009, an American act of Congress passed the Matthew Shepard and James Byrd Jr. Hate Crimes Prevention Act and signed into law by President Barack Obama 6 days later. The law expands the 1969 United States federal hate crime law to include crimes motivated by victims' actual or perceived gender, sexual orientation, gender identity, or disability. Milestones have been met since the Stonewall Uprising of 1969 and the 2015 Supreme Court decision to legalize gay marriage nationwide. Did not end the struggle for equality and protection, so this June, it is important to celebrate how far the U.S. has come in recognizing gay rights and to be extremely proud of that fact, but only if we remember how far we still have to go to ensure that equal rights and dignity of LGBT Americans are recognized under law. And also, let us not forget the rest of the world fighting for those same rights and dignity.
Good morning, CFAY community. This is Petty Officer Fleming. I'm going over the 2000s decade. In December 18, 2010, the United States Senate ruled 6531 to repeal the Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy, allowing gays and lesbians to serve openly in the military. In June 9, 2015, the Secretary of Defense, Ash Carter, announces that the military equal opportunity policy has been adjusted to include gays and lesbian military members. In May 17, 2016, the Senate confirms Eric Fanning to be the Secretary of the Army, making him the first openly gay Secretary in the United States military. Fanning previously served as Defense Secretary Carter's Chief of Staff and also served as Undersecretary of the Air Force and Deputy Undersecretary of the U.S. Navy. It means this man has had a very extensive career proving himself to be worthy of the job. June 24, 2016, Obama announces the designation of the first national monument based to lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender rights. Because of the Stonewall riots, and the Stonewall National Monument will encompass Christopher Park, the Stonewall Inn, and the surrounding streets and sidewalks that were the sites of 1969's Stonewall Uprising.